أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة هود عليه الصلاة والسلام: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره إن أنتم إلا مفترون. يا قوم لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إن أجري إلا على الذي فطرني وأفلا تعقلون. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم ربنا آنس وحشتنا في قبورنا وارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم. اللهم اجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منهما نسينا، وعلمنا منهما جهلنا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. آمين. I told you that these two surahs, Surah Yunus and Surah Hud, alayhim as-salatu was-salam, they are a pair to each other. And the relationship is of reciprocity, reciprocal relationship. That in Surah Yunus, we find only two sections about the Ambaur Rusul, or the important news of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their nations. Here, as a contrast, we find more than half of the surah that contains these Ambaur Rusul. And we had two full sections discussing Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, which we discussed last night. Now, after the people of Nuh, the first nation which rose to prominence and power and splendor and glory among the Semitic nations was the nation of Ad. And the southern area, the broader area of the Arabian Peninsula, was their land. And it was a very fertile land at that time. Shaddad, the famous name, was the name of a king. And it is also said it was the title of the kings of that nation, just as Pharaoh of Egypt and, you know, Namrud of the Chaldean Empire and so on. In the same way, it was a title, or it was a name of a king, Shaddad. And now that city has been, you know, discovered by the satellite. It lies buried deep under the desert. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا. And to the Aad we sent their own brother, Hud. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. He said the same thing, the same message. He said, oh my people, worship Allah alone. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُ. You have no God except Him. إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا مُفْتَرُونَ. You are only forging the names of other deities or gods or goddesses. These are only names which you have invented, nothing else. يَا قَوْمِ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. The same thing. a very common feature about these prophets. They never demanded any, you know, remunerations or any salary or anything from their nations. I don't demand from you any recompense, any remuneration. In adriya illa ala alladhi fatarani, my reward rests only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created me. Afala taqilun. So don't you understand? Wa ya qawm istaghfiru rabbakum summa tubu ilayhi. And O my people, ask the forgiveness of Allah, your Lord. And then you turn towards Him in repentance. Yursil sama alaykum midrara. He will send upon you plenty of rains. وَيَزِدْكُمْ إِلَىٰ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ. And He will add to your strength and power and glory which you already have. فَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْ مُجْرِمِينَ. But please don't turn your backs to what I am saying and you will be guilty then. قَالُوا يَا هُودُ مَا جَيْتَنَا بِبَيِّنَةٍ. The people said, O Hud, you have not brought us any clear miracle, any clear proof. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِتَارِكِ آلِهَتِنَا عَنْ قَوْلِكَ. And we are not going to abandon our lords, our gods, our goddesses, our deities, only for your word, only because of you are saying so. عَنْ قَوْلِكَ. وَمَا نَحْنُ لَكَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we are not going to believe in you. إِنْ نَقُولَ إِنَّا تَرَاكَ بَعْضُ آلِهَتِنَا بِسُوءٍ. What we think is, we don't think anything else but that, some of our gods or goddesses have seized you with some evil because you are repudiating them. You say they don't exist. They have no reality. So some of them, you know, has got offended upon you and he has touched you and seized you with some evil. قَالَ إِنِّي أُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ وَأَشْهَدُ. And he said, I make Allah witness and you also remain witness. إِنِّي بَرِيٌّ مِمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. I am quit, I am free, and I have no fear of those deities or goddesses whom they are making associates with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِن دُونِهِ. You know, besides Him. فَكِيدُونِي جَمِيعًا. Now you devise whatever you can devise. All of you join together. And whatever you can do against me, go ahead. ثُمَّ لَا تُنْذِرُونَ. Don't give me any respite. إِنِّي تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ رَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ. I have all the trust and faith in Allah, who is my Lord as well as your Lord. مَا مِن دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ آخَذٌ بِنَاصِيَتِهَا. There is no animal, no living creature which is creeping on the earth, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is holding it by the forelock, by the hair of the forehead. إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Now this, the literal meaning would be, my Lord is on the straight path. But what does it mean? He has the straight dealing. He deals with His creatures in a straight manner, with justice. And the other meaning can be, He can be approached or pleased only by the straight and right path. Just as we see, as we say, you know, such and such cities are on the highway. إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. If you want to approach Him, if you want to come nearer and nearer to Him, then you have to take the straight path. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ إِلَيْكُمْ. And if you turn away, then I have conveyed to you what I was sent for you with. وَيَسْتَقْلِفُ رَبِّي قَوْمًا. And what I think is that you are going to be destroyed, and after you, my Lord, will bring another nation who will be successors in your place. غَيْرَكُمْ. Another nation. وَلَا تَذُرُّونَهُ شَيْئًا. You will not be able to harm him anything. إِنَّ رَبِّي عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٌ. Definitely, my Lord is guardian over everything. وَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا نَجَّيْنَا هُودًا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. And when our command came, we delivered and saved Hud and the people who had come to believe with him. بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا. And this deliverance was through our mercy. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ غَلِيظٍ. And we saved them and delivered them from the very harsh punishment and chastisement. وَتِلْكَ عَادٌ. And such were the Aad. جَهَدُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. They denied the revelations and the signs of their Lord. وَعَصَوْا رُسُلَهُ. And they disobeyed their messengers. وَاتَّبَعُوا أَمْرَ كُلِّ جَبَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. And they followed the path and the command of all those jabbarin, powerful oppressors, aneed, obstinate, the leaders, you know, their chiefs. These are the two qualities. They were jabbar and they were obstinate. And they were following them anyhow. وَأُتْبِعُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا لَعْنَةٍ. A curse was made to chase them in this world. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And the same curse will be chasing them on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection. أَلَا إِنَّ عَادًا كَفَرُوا رَبَّهُمْ. Behold the Aad, the people of Hud, they disbelieved their Lord. أَلَا بَعْدًا لِعَادٍ قَوْمِ هُود. Away with Aad, the people of Hud. وَإِلَى ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. And to the nation of Samud we sent their own brother Salih, alayhi salatu wassalam. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ عَبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. The same call. Oh my people, worship Allah only. You don't have any God except Him. هُوَ أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَاسْتَعْبَرَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. He has brought you forth and He has made you dwelt in this land. وَاسْتَعْبَرَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. So you must be asking His forgiveness. ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. And then you turn to Him in obedience, in repentance. إن ربي قريب مجيب. My Lord is very near and He is responsive. If you call upon Him, He responds. قالوا يا صالح قد كنت فينا مرجوا قبل هذا. They said, Oh Saleh, we had all the hopes from you before this time. We thought that you will be a big man and a big servant and someone, you know, who will take the nation up and so on, be a hero of our nation. يَا صَالِحُ قَدْ كُنْتَ فِينَا مَرْجُوًا قَبْلَ هَذَا. Before this. Now what have you started? أَتَنْهَانَا أَنْ نَعْبُدَ مَا يَعْبُدَ أَبَاؤُنَا. Now you have started. You want to forbid us from worshipping what our forefathers were worshipping. وَإِنَّنَا لَفِي شَكٍّ مِمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ مُرِيبًا. Verily and certainly about what you are calling us, we are in a doubt, which is perturbing doubt, disquieting doubt. We can't say what you are saying is correct. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ. The same word now again, note, بَيِّنَة. He said, Oh my people, do you consider, if I was on the self-evident light from my Lord, Bir Rabbi, my nature was, you know, pure, and that is why you were hoping from me so many things, and you had pinned your hopes to me. It means I was of different nature from most of you. أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي. I had already that pure nature and that self-evident light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآتَانِي مِنْهُ رَحْمَةً. And over and above that, He gave me His mercy. He chose me as a messenger. He sent revelations to me. فَمَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي. مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ أَسَيْتُهُ. Now, if I disobey Him, who will be able to help me against Him? فَمَا تَزِيدُونَنِي غَيْرَ تَخْسِيرٍ. Definitely you won't be able to add to me except loss and disaster. وَيَا قَوْمِ هَذِهِ نَاقَةُ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ آيَةٌ. And O my people, this she-camel is the sign of Allah. This is the she-camel of Allah. فَذَرُوهَا تَعْقُلْ فِي الْأَرْضِ فِي أَرْضِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَمَسُّوهَا بِسُوءٍ. Now leave it alone so that it grazes in the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فِي أَرْضِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَمَسُّوهَا بِسُوءٍ. Don't touch her with any evil intentions. فَيَأْخُذَكُمْ عَذَابٌ قَرِيبٌ. Then you know a chastisement, a punishment which is very near will come over you. فَعَقَرُوهَا. But they hamstrung her, killed her. فَقَالَ تَمَتَّعُوا فِي دَارِكُمْ ثَلَاثَةَ أَيَّامٍ. He said, okay, now only 3 days are left for you. You enjoy your life or your living in your homes for 3 days. ذَلِكَ وَعْدٌ غَيْرُ مَكْذُوبٍ. After these 3 days, their chastisement would come. And this is a promise which will never be broken. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا نَجَّيْنَا صَالِحًا. And when our command came, we delivered and saved Salih alayhi salatu wasalam, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ, and those who were with him, بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا, by mercy from us. وَمِنْ خِزْيِ يَوْمِئِذْ, and the humiliation of that day, they were saved from that. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ الْقَوِيُّ الْعَظِيزُ. Verily, certainly, your Lord is Qawi, the Omnipotent, Al-Aziz, having all authority. وَأَخَذَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا الصَّيْحَةُ. And those who were the evildoers, they were seized by an awful cry, awful killing cry or blast. فَأَصْبَحُوا فِي دِيَارِهِمْ جَاسِمِينَ. So they became dead, lying in their houses, in their dwellings, on their own faces, prostrating. كَلَّمْ يَغْنَوْ فِيهَا. And they become as if they never dwelt over there. أَلَا إِنَّ سَمُودَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. Behold, Samud also disbelieved their Lord. أَلَا بُعْدًا لِسَمُود. So, away with Samud also. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ بِالْبُشْرَى. قَالُوا سَلَامًا. قَالَ سَلَامٌ فَمَا لَبِسَ أَنْ جَاءَ بِعِجْلٍ حَنِيسٍ. Now, please note the point here. Here, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam is being mentioned. And you know the sequence is Hazrat Nuh, Hazrat Hud, Hazrat Saleh and Ibrahim. But you'll find a very basic difference. The style is absolutely different. Nothing about what happened to his nation, what was his call to the nation, and you know, what the nation responded. The style is absolutely different. Only an incident regarding, you know, the angels which were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the destruction of the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. Before going there, they visited Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam and they gave him the glad tidings of his son to be born to Hazrat Sarah salamu alayha. Now this is the only thing here. So it's a very big difference. It must be noted. What is the connotation? That I am not going to discuss, you know, because in this rapid translation, these things cannot be discussed in detail. But you have to note the difference, and you know, you ponder yourself, maybe you reach the same conclusion. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ بِالْبُشْرَى. And our messengers, that is the angels, but they were in the guise of human beings. They came to Ibrahim with a glad tiding. قَالُوا سَلَامًا. They said, Salam, Salamu alaykum. قَالَ سَلَامٌ. He returned Islam with greeting. وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامُ. فَمَا لَبِسَ أَنْ جَاءَ بِعِجْلٍ. He didn't delay even a minute, but he went to his household and brought a roasted calf. Anjab ijlin hanis. Falamma ra'a aydiyahum. Now he placed that calf, roasted calf, before these guests. But when he saw their hands not moving toward that calf, they were not, no, extending their hands toward it. Nakirahum. Now he became suspicious. Who are they? وَأَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفًا. And he felt, you know, conceived some fear in his heart. Because, you know, in those tribal days, it was the custom, you know, if somebody or some people went to do some harm to others, they won't eat from their house. At least they were so noble. To whom we are going to kill and the whom, you know, we are going to rob or, you know, whatsoever, they don't, at least don't eat from their house. So when Hazrat Ibrahim saw that he had not ready to eat, أَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفًا. And he find that maybe they are some enemies and they have come to do some harm to me. قَالُوا لَا تَخَفْ. They said, don't feel any fear. إِنَّا أُرْسِلْنَا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِ لُوت. We have been sent to the people of Lut. وَمْرَاتُهُ قَائِمَةٌ. And his wife, Hazrat Sarah, salamu alayhi, was also standing. Might be standing behind some curtain. فَزَهِكَتْ. She laughed. What happened to my husband, you know? He became fearful of these guests. And this, something else now has come out. They are no enemies. فَزَهِكَتْ. She laughed. فَبَشَّرْنَاهَا بِإِسْحَاقِ. These messengers gave her the glad tidings of the son, that is Ishaq. وَمِنْ وَرَاءِ إِسْحَاقَ يَعْقُوبُ. And not only of the son, but also of the grandson. After Ishaq, after him, a grandson, Yaqub. قَالَتْ يَا وَيْلَتَا أَلِدُ وَأَنَا عُجُودٌ وَهَذَا بَعْلِي شَيْخًا. She said, woe unto me! Shall I bear a child? And when I am so old a woman, and this my husband is also very old. إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. This is a very strange thing. What you are telling? قَالُوا وَتَعْجَبِينَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ عَلَيْكُمْ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ. They said, oh people of the house of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Now note the word here, Ahlul Bayt. This Ahlul Bayt comes for wife. Ahl al-Tashayyu have used this word in a different sense. In Surah Al-Ahzab, fi ayat al-Tathir, primarily the wives of the Prophet of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they are meant. And only according to hadith, the Prophet had said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about Hazrat Hassan, Hazrat Hussain, Hazrat Ali, Hazrat Fatima, they are also from my Ahlul Bayt. Now you know the primary Ahlul Bayt deleted. And only Ahlul Bayt now are Ali and Fatima and Hassan and Hussain, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. They are also according to the hadith. But according to the Quran, the real Ahlul Bayt, they were the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the proof is here. They said, peace be upon you, O wife of Ibrahim. Are you wondering about the command of Allah? He can do anything. This old age of yours or old age of your husband is no bar to him. Innahu hamidum majid. Verily, he is self-praised or praiseworthy. You can translate hamid in two ways, praiseworthy or self-praised. One who doesn't need any praise, who is above praise. Majid, and he is glorious. فَلَمَّا ذَهَبَ عَنْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الرَّوْعُ. When this fear had departed from Ibrahim, وَجَاءَتْهُ الْبُشْرَى. And now the glad tiding came to him. يُجَاجَلُنَا فِي قَوْمِ لُوتِ. Now he started arguing and disputing with us regarding the nation of Lut. If there are, you know, this much detail is given in Torah. Maybe there are 50 persons over there. And if they are righteous persons, the angel said, okay, if we find 50 righteous persons in those cities, we won't, you know, bring any chastisement to it. Then he said, okay, let me again call to my Lord. Maybe there are 45. Then what will he have? Okay, or 45 also. If 45 are there, we shall spare the cities. And so on. It came to even 5. But then, you know, final word in Torah is also the same which is now appearing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran is cutting long story short. So he left all those details, but they are given in there, disputed. He was yudajaluna, he was arguing us. And you know, he was asking for forgiveness for that nation. Inna Ibrahima la halimun awwahum munib. Verily, Ibrahim was forbearing, halim. Awwahun, always invoking him. Munib, always turning towards him. Ya Ibrahim wa aridan haza. But in the end it was said to him, O Ibrahim, now just leave it alone. Innahu qad jaa amru rabbik. The command of your Lord has already come. Wa innahum atihim azabun ghayrum mardood. And now to them is going to come the punishment which cannot be averted, which cannot be returned. وَلَمَّا جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا. Now, Hazrat Lut alayhi salam. Now, about Hazrat Ibrahim, the only incident. Not the stories like Hazrat Hud, Hazrat Nuh, Hazrat Saleh. And again we shall have Hazrat Lut, Hazrat Shu'aib, Hazrat Musa. Three, I told you, pre-Abrahamic, three post-Abrahamic. And here, Hazrat Ibrahim is also situated in between. But we found in Surah Al-Anam, only Hazrat Ibrahim mentioned. And Surah Al-Araf, all the six, the three pre-Abrahamic era and three belonging to the post-Abrahamic era. But there was no mention of Ibrahim in Surah Al-Araf. Here, although Ibrahim has been mentioned here in Surah Al-Hud, but you know, the style is absolutely different. وَلَمَّا جَاتْ رُسُلُنَا لُوتًا. And when our messengers came to Lut, alayhi salatu wasalam, see abihim. He was perturbed to see them. وَزَاقَتْ بِهِمْ زَرْهًا. And you know, he was distressed for them. Why? He thought, because, you know, these messengers which were sent to him, they were in the form of handsome boys. Now, this wickedness of that nation was, he feared that now my nation will come, people will come, and they will assault them sexually. And I will not be able to, you know, stop them, because I don't have any power. There are no mu'mineen with me. Nobody, you know, believed in him, in the whole of the two cities. He lived in Sodom. And that is why this act is called sodomy. It is, you know, related to that city. قَالَ هَذَا يَوْمٌ عَصِيبٌ And he said, oh, this is going to be a very hard day for me. وَجَاءَ قَوْمُهُ يُهْرَعُونَ إِلَيْهِ And now the people of this city came to him running. وَمِنْ قَبْلُ كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ And they were given to these, you know, these wicked things and these evil acts before that. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ هَاُولَاءِ بَنَاتِهُنَّ أَطْهَرُ لَكُمْ He said, oh my people, these are my daughters, they are more purer for you. You should go towards them to satisfy your sexual urge. Now there are two interpretations. هَاُولَاءِ بَنَاتِ Your wives in your homes, they are just like daughters to me. Because, you know, the Nabi, the Prophet, and the Rasul, he is like father to the whole of the nation. And you know, as the wives of the Prophet are mothers, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتٌ لَهُمْ But the second thing is, that maybe he might have offered his own daughters, that I can give them to you in nikah. You marry them. If you are, you know, overwhelmed with some sexual urge, okay, the right path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened for you. هَاُولَاءِ بَنَاتِهُنَّ أَثَرُ لَكُمْ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ So, fear Allah. Must regard Allah. وَلَا تُخْزُونِ فِي زَيْفِي And don't put me to humiliation regarding my guests. أَلَيْسَ مِنْكُمْ رَجُلٌ نَشِيدٌ Is there not a single person rightly guided up among you? قَالُوا لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا لَنَا فِي بَنَاتِكَ مِنْ حَقٍ Now look, see how much, you know, truth-loving people they were. How much they said, you know that we don't have any right on your daughters. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَعْلَمُ مَا تُرِيدُ You very well know what we want, what we intend to do. You very well know. قَالَ لَوْ أَنَّ لِي بِكُمْ قُوَّةً أَوْ آوِي لَا رُكْنٍ شَدِيدٍ You know, in a very sad voice he said, Would that I had power against you, or I could take refuge and support from someone who was very powerful. Now this ayah, about this we have a hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, يَرْحَمُ اللَّهُ لُوتًا لَقَدْ كَانَ يَعْوِي بِرُكْنٍ شَدِيدٍ May Allah have mercy on Lut. He had that support already with him. That was the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you know, at that time of distress, he was, you know, mentioning the support, the visible support, or the material support. I have no companions, I have no, you know, people to help me against you. So in that way, he was saying, لَوْ أَنَّ لِي بِكُمْ قُوَّةً أَوْ آوِي إِلَىٰ رُكْنٍ شَدِيدٍ The Ruknin Shadeed was there, and he was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالُوا يَا لُوتُ إِنَّا رُسُلُ رَبِّكُ They said, O Lut, we are the messengers of your Lord. لَنْ يَسِلُوا إِلَيْكُ They will not come, they will not be able to come to, near to you. فَأَصْرِ بِأَهْلِكَ بِقِطْعٍ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ Now you just go out of this city before the ending of the night. A part of the night, you know, remains and you should go. وَلَا يَلْتَفِدْ مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا امْرَأَتَكُ And none of you should turn, you know, to these people, should pay any attention to these people, except your wife. إِنَّهُ مُصِيبُهَا مَا أَصَابَكُمْ Surely whatsoever befalls them shall befall her also. إِنَّ مَوْعِدَهُمُ الصُّبْحَ Verily, the time of their promise is the dawn. أَلَيْسَ الصُّبْحُ بِقَرِيبٍ Is the dawn not very near? So, make haste. Now you leave the place. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا So when our command came, جَعَلْنَا عَالِيَهَا سَافِلَهَا We overturned the city upside down. وَأَمْتَرْنَا عَلَيْهَا حِجَارَةً مِّن سِجِّيلٍ And we rained over it the rain of baked clay. Now this is Sijjil. This is a word adopted from Persian into Arabic. Sangegil. Sangegil is stones, you know, small stones. Because in deserts, you know, if there is some drizzling, each water drop has some play with it. And now it becomes sort of a grain. And when there is heat of the sun, it is baked. So these become small stones, you know, just like the bullets. So actually this is Sangegil, this is Persian. But when it has been taken into Arabic, Muarrab, now it becomes Sijjil, Sangegil. So these were actually the raining, you know, just like the hailstorm. It was the raining of these baked stones of the desert. Manzood, and they came one after the other, and so as to heap, you know, they were heaped over the town. And these towns, you know, mostly they were drowned. They were situated, both of them, on the banks of the, on the coast of the Dead Sea. And then most of it were drowned in it. Musawwamatan in the Rabbik. And they were marked from your Lord, each one for each one of them. وَمَا هِيَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ. And what is here? The township. The ruins of those towns, you know, they were present till the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these caravans, trade caravans, when they used to go to Syria from Hijaz, they used to pass by the ruins of these towns. And this town, you know, township on which this thing happened is not very far off from them. وَمَا هِيَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. These evildoers, you know, the Quraysh, they also know the town where this thing happened, the Ba'id. وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَا أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. And to the Madians, we sent their own brother, Shu'ayb. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ بُدُلْ. I told you, Madian was also a son of Hazrat Ibrahim from his third wife, Qatura. They are called Banu Qatura, the progeny of Qatura. Ishaq from Sarah, Ismail from Hajra, Madian and many others from Qatura. But the most important name among them was Madian. وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَا أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. Now the progeny of Madian. Now they are the tribe of Madian, and where they lived, that was on the right side, on the right bank, or the eastern bank of the Gulf of Aqaba. So actually when the caravans went from Hijaz, from Makkah, etc. to Syria, they passed first by the ruins of Samud, then came the ruins of this Madian, then came the ruins of Sodom and Gomorrah, and then they used to go to Palestine. So all these townships, you know, they were on that highway of the caravans, you know. وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَا أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. I think that don't need to translate these words now. لَا تَنْقُصُوا الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانَ. Don't diminish neither the measure nor the weight. إِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ بِخَيْرٍ. I am saying you that you are in prosperity. Now please note, actually this region was at the crossroads of two main caravan routes. One caravan routes coming from the south, going to the north, from Hijaz to Syria or back from Syria to Hijaz. Other was the main caravan route from Iraq to Egypt. And that passed, you know, through the Gaza Strip. And they actually, this nation was occupying, you know, at the crossroads. So they benefited the most. Caravans coming, caravans going, as you know, cities who are situated on such highways and, you know, caravan routes, they benefit and they prosper. إِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ بِخَيْرٍ. I am seeing that you are in prosperity. إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ مُحِيطٍ. But I fear that, you know, if you don't mend your ways, the chastisement of an encircling day will come over you. وَيَا قَوْمِ أَوْفُ الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانَ. You should fulfill the measure also and the weights also. بِالْقِسْطِ, with justice. وَلَا تَبْخَسُ النَّاسَ أَشْيَاءَهُمْ. And don't diminish people, their goods. وَلَا تَعْصَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ. And don't create, go about creating in the earth a mischief. بَقِيَّةُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. What is left over, as the right prophet, you know, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is better for you. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are believers. وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِحَفِيظٍ. Then I am not a guardian over you. Only I am admonishing you. I am giving you the best and sincere advice. قَالُوا يَا شُعَيْبُ وَصَلَاتُكَ تامرك أن نترك ما يعبد آباؤنا أو أن نفعل في أموالنا ما نشاء. Now these two things are very important. They said, O shrine, does your prayer, we see you praying in some peculiar way, but okay, you can go and pray, this is your personal affair, but you know, does your prayer, tamuroka, commands you, ordains upon you, an natroka ma yabudu abhavna, that we should abandon those gods whom our forefathers were worshipping? أَوْ أَنْ نَفْعَلَ فِي أَمْوَالِنَا مَا نَشَاءُ. Or you want to forbid us, and your prayer forbids us from doing us whatever we want to do in our own belongings. Now this is actually the basic principle of capitalism. The sacred right of ownership. This belongs to me. I can do with it anything I like. This is the sacred, most sacred, you know, right of ownership. I am the owner, I can do whatever I like. I can invest as I like. Well, if I can open a brothel, I don't say that everybody should come, I can't compel anybody, but if anybody wants to come, okay, let him come. He is free to come or not to come, but I should be free to invest my money in any way I like. Well, I am, you know, giving people loans on interest. This is my money. I can't give them without any reward, for any exchange for that. But they are not compelled to take from me. But if they want to take any loan from me, well, they are free to take the loan or not to take the loan. And I am free to charge the interest. So this is basically the sacred right of ownership, which is the basis of capitalism. And these words, you know, denote, أَوْ أَنْ نَفْعَلَ فِي أَمْوَالِنَا مَا نَشَاءُ. They thought, we are free, these are our belongings, our properties, we can do anything with them which we like. إِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ الْحَلِيمُ الرَّشِيدُ. Surely you are the only Halim and Rashid, and you are the only forbearing and rightly guided person. It was a sarcastic remark. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ كُنْتُ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي. The same thing again. He said, oh my nation, oh my people, just consider, if I was already, from my youth you have been seeing me, if I was already on a self-evident light from my rod, that is the human nature, pure human nature, I had that light from the very beginning. وَرَزَقَنِي مِنْهُ رِزْقًا حَسَنًا. And over and above that, my Lord has given me very good risk. You know, this wahi is also risk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided this risk, this spiritual risk. As I said, you know, that what is this psalm and what is Quran? In the psalm, we are to some extent withholding the nourishment from our animal being. And then during the night, we want to provide nourishment to our spirits, the souls. And that is Quran. Because our arwah, what are they? يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Now our bodies, our physical existence, it has come from the clay. And the nourishment for it are also coming from the clay. And our ruh, our spirits, they have come from Lord. And the nourishment for them also has come from the Lord, the same source. So, وَرَزَقَنِي مِنْهُ رِزْقًا حَسَنًا وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ أُخَالِفَكُمْ إِلَى مَا أَنْهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ. And I desire not to stop you from something and then do that myself, which I forbid you. إِنْ أُرِيدُ إِلَّا الْإِصْلَاحِ. I don't intend anything except reform. مَسْتَطَعْتُ, as much as I can. وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And I draw all my strength and ability from Allah, from none except Allah. وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ. And I have placed my trust on him. وَإِلَيْهِ نُيب. And to him I turn. وَيَا قَوْمِ لَا يَجْزِمَنَّكُمْ شِقَاقِي. And look, my people, it shouldn't be that my enmity incites you. أَنْ يُسِيبَكُمْ مِسْلُمَا أَصَابَ قَوْمَ نُوحٍ أَوْ قَوْمَ هُودٍ أَوْ قَوْمَ صَالِحٍ. Because you are, you know, in my enmity, personal grudge against me, you are not accepting, you know, my dawah, my advice. But what will be the result? That, you know, the same punishment would come to you that came to the people of Nuh and the people of Hud or the people of Saleh, وَمَا قَوْمُ لُوتٍ مِّنْكُمْ بِبَعِيدٍ, and the people of Lut, you know, they were not very far off from you. As I told you, they are very closely situated. قَوْمِ Lut, then قَوْمِ Shu'ayb, and then geographically speaking, from south to the north, قَوْمِ Lut, then قَوْمِ Samud, and then, you know, قَوْمِ Shu'ayb, and then قَوْمِ Lut, and then the way, you know, all the way towards, you know, Palestine. وَمَا قَوْمُ لُوتٍ مِّنْكُمْ بِبَعِيدٍ, وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبِّكُمْ, and you know this ba'id in both ways, zaman as well as makan, because they were nearby, situated, and actually they were very close in timings, because قَوْمِ Lut, Hazrat Lut alayhi salam, was the nephew of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. So actually the time period was also not very, very long in between them. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ, and you should ask the forgiveness from your Lord, and you turn to Him in repentance. إِنَّ رَبِّي رَحِيمٌ وَدُودٌ, verily my Lord is Rahim, merciful, and Wadood, very loving. قَالُوا يَا شُعَيْبُ مَا نَفْقَهُ كَثِيرًا مِمَّا تَقُولُ, they said, oh Shu'ayb, most of what you say is unintelligible to us. We can't understand what you are saying, you know. مَا نَفْقَهُ كَثِيرًا مِمَّا تَقُولُ, وَإِنَّا لَنَاكَ فِينَا ضَعِيفًا, and we find that you are not very strong amongst us. You are a weak person. وَلَوْلَا رَحْتُكَ, had we not, you know, considered your family, your tribe, لَلَجَمْنَاكَ, we would have stoned you to death. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْنَا بِعَزِيزٍ, and you personally are not strong against us. We could have eliminated you long before, but for your family. Now you see, this is a mirror shown to them, to the Quraysh of Makkah. Because, you know, they were also holding back due to Banu Hashim. Banu Hashim were supporting. Abu Talib as chief of Bani Hashim was supporting Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, you know, these people, Abu Jahl and so on, and or Uqba ibn Mu'ayt, they would have cut him into pieces long before. But because there was the, you know, support of Banu Hashim, because the chief of Banu Hashim, he was Abu Talib, and Abu Talib loved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no doubt, from the depth of his heart. Although he didn't believe in him, and he didn't, you know, exclaim the Shahada, even at the time of his death, although the Prophet requested him personally. But actually, we all of us owe much to Abu Talib, that he supported and helped the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is, you know, a mirror being shown to Quraysh. Whatever is happening to you today, that was the case with the people of Madian. They couldn't take any step against Hazrat Shu'ayb due to his family. وَلَوْلَا رَحْتُكَ لَرَجَمْنَاكَ وَمَا أَنْتَمْ عَلَيْنَا بِعَزِيزٍ, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ رَحْتِي عَزُّ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ, he said, oh my nation, my people, my family is more awful for you than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't fear Allah and you fear my family. فَاتَّخَذْتُمُوهُ وَرَاكُمْ ذِهْرِيًّا, and you have put Allah on your backs, just forgot Him. You don't care about Him. You have no fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ رَبِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ, verily, whatever you are doing, my Lord encircles it already. You can't do anything. You can't move without His permission. وَيَا قَوْمِ مَلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ, and okay, oh my nation, now do whatever you can do. Strive your utmost against me. Inni amil, I am also trying my best. I'll be striving to my utmost. So fata'alamun, very soon you'll come to know. Man yatihi azabun, to whom comes that punishment, yukhzihi, which will humiliate him. Wa man huwa kazib, and who is the liar. Wartaqibu, and wait. Inni ma'akum raqib, and I am also watching with you. You also go on watching, and I am also watching. وَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا نَجَّيْنَا شُعَيْبًا, when our command came, we saved and delivered شُعَيْب وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ, and those believers who were with him. بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا, the same verse, with mercy from us. وَأَخَذَتِ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا السَّيْحَةَ, again here the same word. An awful sound, a blast, a killing sound seized them. فَأَصْبَحُوا فِي دِيَارِهِمْ جَاسِمِينَ, and they also were overturned on their faces in their houses, prostrating. Kallam yaghnaw fiha, and they also became as if they never dwelt over there. Ala bawdan li Madyan, Oh, away with Madian. Kama ba'idat Samud, as Samud had been done away. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا. Now you know, we had one section of this surah devoted to the four, two to Hazrat Nuh. And you'll find only a few lines about Hazrat Musa. Just the converse, the reciprocal ratio of what was the case in Surah Yunus. Surah Yunus, out of the total two, one and a half were devoted to the story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. Only half to Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. And all the rest not even mentioned by name, only collectively. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا وَسُلْطَانٍ مُبِينٍ. And we had sent Musa بِآيَاتِنَا with our signs, وَسُلْطَانٍ مُبِينٍ, and a clear authority, إِلَى فِرَعَوْنَ وَمَلَئِهِ, to Pharaoh and his chiefs. فَاتَّبَعُوا أَمْرَ فِرَعَوْنَ. But these people, they followed the command of Pharaoh. They didn't follow Musa. They didn't believe in Musa. Because, you know, they were under that coercion. فَاتَّبَعُوا أَمْرَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَا أَمْرُ فِرْعَوْنَ بِرَشِيدٍ. And, you know, the command of Fir'aun was not rightly guided. يَقْدُمُ قَوْمَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. He will come ahead of his nation, as if leading, you know, leading procession. He will be ahead of them. يَقْدُمُ قَوْمَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, on the day of judgment. فَأَوْرَدَهُمُ النَّارِ. And he will have led them down to the fire. بِئْسَ الْوِرْدُ الْمَوْرُودُ. Even is the place to which they will be led. وَأُتْبَعُوا فِي هَذِهِ لَعْنَةً. And a curse was made to chase them in this world also. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, on the day of judgment also. بِئْسَ الْوِرْدُ الْمَرْفُودُ. A very bad gift and offering which will be offered to them. ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْقُرَىٰ. These are the big news, important news of the townships. نَقُصَّهُ عَلَيْكُ. We are relating them to you. مِنْهَا قَائِمٌ. Out of these townships, some are existing till today. مِنْهَا قَائِمٌ وَحَسِيدٌ. And some are like fields harvested. You know, when there is some harvest, and after the harvest has been reaped, now what is the scene of that field? Though so many, you know, are ruins like a field which has been already been reaped. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. وَلَكِنْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. And we didn't wrong them, but they actually wronged themselves. فَمَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمُ الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. But now, then, you know, whenever command came to them of punishment, those gods whom they were calling upon, praying, you know, instead of us, they didn't avail them anything. لَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُ رَبِّكَ. When the command of your Lord came. وَمَا زَادُوهُمْ غَيْرَ تَدْبِينَ. And they didn't increase for them except ruin. وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَىٰ. And such is the seizure of your Lord when he seizes the towns. وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ. When those towns are evil doings, evil doers, they are occupied and inhabited by evil doers. In أَخْزَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Verily, his seizing is painful and very severe. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَةً لِمَنْ خَافَ عَذَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. And in this history, these tales of the history, in this is a sign. There is a lesson. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَةً لِمَنْ خَافَ عَذَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. Whosoever fears the chastisement and punishment of the hereafter. I've been telling you time again that this is the basic thing. Whosoever has some thought of Akhirah, well, he will sooner or later take to the right path. He will mend his ways. He will reform himself. But if there is no, you know, idea of Akhirah at all this wisdom, all this preaching, all this teaching goes in vain. ذَلَكَ يَوْمُ مَجْمُولُ لَهُ النَّاسِ. That is a day when all mankind will be collected. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ مَشْهُودٌ. And that is the day on all will have to be present. All will be present before their Lord. وَمَا نُوَخِّرُهُمْ إِلَّا لِأَجَلٍ مَعْدُودٍ. And we are not postponing it, but for an appointed time. It has already been appointed. The time has been fixed. يَوْمَ يَعْتِ لَا تَكَلَّمُ نَفْسٌ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. When that day comes, no soul will be able to say anything, to pronounce any word, except بِإِذْنِهِ, except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمِنْهُمْ شَقِيٌّ وَسَعِيدٌ. From among them, there will be the shaqi and sa'id. There will be the people, wretched people, doomed people. And there will be people who will be blessed. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ شَقُوا فِي النَّارِ. So those who are doomed, they will be put in the fire. لَهُمْ فِيهَا زَفِيرٌ وَشَهِيقٌ. And they will go on sighing and wailing and mourning continuously there. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. They will remain therein forever. مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. So long as the heavens and the earth remain. إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ رَبُّكَ. Except what your Lord decrees. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. Verily your Lord does whatever He intends. Now this is a very peculiar place of the Quran, where this, you know, eternity of the fire of hell, and also in the same way we shall find the eternity of Jannah, it has been, you know, surrounded by two exceptions. Number one, there is going to be a limit, so to say. مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. But that what theoretical means, maybe a time comes when all these heavens and earth, they are finished with. This universe might come to an absolute end. Then it means, according to the verse, the Jahannam will also come to an end. So most of our, you know, the scholars and mufassireen and mutakallimeen of Ahlul Sunnah, they say, these are only idiomatic words. Actually, it means forever, 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 forever. مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. It's an idiom for eternity. But there are certain people, there have been certain people, I should say, who say that Jahannam is not eternal. It will come to an end. Although the period is going to be very long, very long, very long. The length, you know, is unimaginable for us. Very long, as if eternity. But it is not going to be eternity. And it's very strange that two very notable persons of the Ummah, who are very much opposed to each other in nearly every other respect except this, they are, you know, in agreement over this issue. I'm referring to Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah and Ibn Arabi. On the one side, Ibn Taymiyyah. On the other side, Ibn Arabi. Yeah, you know, like, you know, opposite poles of the magnet, you know. So actually, but on this issue they agree, both Ibn Taymiyyah as well as Ibn Arabi, that Jahannam is not eternal. A time will come when all people, either they should be exterminated, finished. If they didn't have any iman, any grain of iman, they will just be finished. No existence. And if there was some grain of iman, a time will come that they will take her out. And about this, you know, the other people also agree that if there is some amount of iman in the heart of a person, then a time will come that he will come out from Jahannam and he will be then admitted to Jannah. But you know that Jahannam will come to an end. This is not the belief of most of the Muslims. But Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Arabi, it is very strange enough that both of them, they agree on this point. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ سُعِدُوا فَفِي الْجَنَّةِ. As for those who will be blessed, they will be in the Jannah, they will be in the garden, خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. And they will be living there. مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ رَبُّكَ. So long as the heavens and the earth will remain, except what your Lord decrees. Now, this, you know, confirms the point of view of those people who say it is idiomatic. Atan ghaira majzuz. And this will be a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will never be break, which will never come to an end. Fala taku fi miryatin mimma ya'budu haula. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or O listener or reader of this book, don't be in any doubt about those whom these people are worshipping. مَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا مَا كَمَا يَعْبُدُ آبَاهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. They are also worshipping, just as their forefathers used to worship. وَإِنَّا لَمُوَفُّوهُمْ نَصِيبَهُمْ غَيْرَ مَنْقُوصٍ. And we shall pay them in full their portion, undiminished. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ فَاخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِنْهُ مُرِيبٍ. And we gave the book to Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام, فَاخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ. But people, you know, differed about it. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. And had the word not passed from your Lord, that a time has been fixed, it would have been decided between them. لَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِنْهُ مُرِيبٍ. And now they have, you know, doubts about it. And these doubts are perturbing. وَإِنَّ كُلَّ لَمَّا لَيُوَفِّيَنَّهُمْ رَبُّكَ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. And surely to each one of them your Lord will pay them in full for their deeds. إِنَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Verily whatever they are doing, and he is aware of it. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you stand firm as you have been ordered and commanded. وَمَنْ تَعْبَ مَعْكَ. And so should do those who have repented with you, that is, who have left that shirk and kufr, and they have come to believe with you. وَلَا تَتْغَوْ. Don't exceed. Don't exceed the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and don't exceed the limits of decency. Even, you know, if the enemies, they behave indecently to you, but you have to remain, you know, your behavior should remain decent. إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Whatever you are doing, he is seeing it. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. And don't incline towards those who are evildoers, even if they are your fathers or brothers or sons or daughters and so on. But don't incline towards them. Because these are, you know, Makki ayat. And we have read this subject in the strongest terms in the Madani surahs. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَرْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. But here, because you know these are the Makki surahs. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا فَتَمَسَّكُمُ النَّارُ. Don't incline towards those who are evildoers. Then fire will touch you. وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ أَوْلِيَاءَ. You will not find besides Allah any protector. وَلَا تُنْصَرُونَ. And you will not be helped from any corner. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. And establish salah on both ends of the day, sides of the day, morning and evening. وَاذْكُرِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. We find it, you know, in the beginning, these were the two main prayers. Morning prayer, evening prayer. وَذُرَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. And some part of the night also. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسْجُدْ لَهُ. For example, we find it at other places also. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ. Verily, the good deeds, they wash off the bad deeds. About the sagair, you know, they are automatically washed off by good deeds. If you have committed sagair, the smaller, you know, sins, and you are committing something, doing something good also, so these smaller sins are wiped off automatically. Although you have not made any tawbah and, you know, conscious any repentance, but these things are إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَ لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. And this is reminding for those who want to have the reminding, who want to remember and want to be mindful. وَاصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And be patient, persevere. And let it be known to you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to waste the reward of the good doers. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafani wa iyaakum bil ayati wa zikr al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar,
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.